You're watching Proactive Investors. Thanks for joining us. I'm Karen Tan. And with me in the Sydney studio is Richard Bevan, the Managing Director of Cassini Resources. Welcome, Richard.
Hi, Karen.
Another visitor from the West.
Over from the West, yes.
Lovely to see you here.
Thanks.
Now, you're also here for a company mining presentation in Sydney.
Yeah.
What's that about? What have you presented and how's that going?
So the conference is the RIU conference that's here sort of annually.
Yeah.
There are about 60 companies presenting, and I presented yesterday to a range of investors, so it was great.
How did it go?
Good. Yeah, we've got a lot going on at the moment in our project and for the company, so a good time to update everyone.
And were you pleased with the participants there?
Yeah, absolutely. We've got a number of existing shareholders over here. So good opportunity to come and give them a bit of an update face to face and tell them what's going on.
Any highlights from the project?
Yeah, there are lots of highlights for us. We've had a lot of momentum through the project over the last 6 months during the pre-feasibility stage. We're looking to deliver through our joint venture partner, Oz Minerals, a study update sort of early in Q3 next year. And there's lots of exploration work going on, so really a fair bit of work.
And that's, you're talking about the West Musgrave project?
Yeah, which is our primary project. And we've had some great results through that work program with around the metallurgy and with the resource drill out. So we're looking really optimistic towards a really positive PFS.
And you recently, or last month in fact, in April, had your capital raising. How did that go? Pleased with the results?
Yeah, it went really well. We were able to introduce some really good quality investors onto the register. We were able to do the raise at a slight premium, which is unusual in this environment. So that was a really good endorsement of the company and our strategy and the project. Probably the most notable of that was a Chinese battery manufacturer, Tinci Materials, who have come on. So good support for the company, and they're there to support us and get the project into production.
That's good. How exactly are they going to support you?
They're really there. They're looking to build a relationship sort of secure some product at the end of the day, some offtake. Whilst it's a bit early to do that, it's a great sign that their belief in the project and to develop that relationship over the next few months as we progress.
That's a huge boost for the company, especially for the market down the track in Asia.
It is, and I think it also points to us building our capability to fund Cassini's part of the project going forwards, which is a key sort of, I guess, challenge of the company over the next sort of 12 to 18 months.
So going ahead with that focus, what is lying ahead in the next 12 to 18 months? Have you got a plan ahead, a strategy?
Yeah, so as I said, the pre-feas will be delivered sort of early Q3 next year. I think that'll be a real milestone for the project and provide some visibility around the economics and the metrics of the project. We're also doing a lot of exploration work, both within the West Musgrave project that's funded by our joint venture partner, Oz, and also in our own right. We've got two other sort of 100% Cassini-owned projects in Western Australia, one in another nickel-copper project and a gold project. So for us, keen to get back on the ground out there and give our shareholders some exposure to some exploration opportunities.
Back on the plane tomorrow?
Back on the plane tomorrow for the quick trip home.
Richard Bevan, thanks so much for the update and your time today.
Thanks, Karen.
That's Richard Bevan, the Managing Director of Cassini Resources.